Welcome to the Disability Granted channel. This video is about a very important topic. It's about the Medicare gap. You know, after all, one of the reasons that people apply for Social Security disability is to get medical care. You know, we hear about financial benefits, but medical care, it's very, very important. After all, those who apply for Social Security disability, those who receive Social Security disability have severe disabling conditions. They need medical care and they need it now. This video isn't meant to be a complaint against Social Security. Social Security is a treasure. It's not a gift. It took decades of hard work for us to have Social Security disability. It took a long, hard fight. We're fortunate to have a Social Security disability program. Commentary on this channel is not meant to criticize Social Security. It's not intended to be a complaint. It's not intended to attack Social Security. Commentary on the Disability Granted channel is intended to make Social Security and Congress aware of certain issues. It's also meant to make Social Security and Congress aware that we know of those issues. So that brings us back to our topic, the Medicare gap. Social Security provides Medicaid to those who receive SSI disability, Supplemental Security Income disability. SSI recipients receive Medicaid and they receive it without delay. That's good. However, Social Security doesn't do that for SSDI recipients, Social Security Disability Insured. Unlike those who win SSI, those who win SSDI don't receive health care immediately. No, they're eligible for Medicare, but they're not eligible for Medicare until 24 months after the initial onset of their severe disabling condition. It's 2 years. For example, if you're awarded SSDI on January 1st, 2024, and your disability began January 1st of 2023, 12 months before, and your disability began 12 months earlier on January 1st, 2023, you won't be eligible for Medicare until 12 months later on January 1st, 2025. Many authorities call that the Medicare gap. And there may be exceptions. For example, those who suffer end-stage renal failure are exempt from the Medicare gap. There's a link and phone number below. I haven't found any other serious medical conditions that are exempted from the Medicare gap, but that doesn't mean there aren't any. And I hope that there are. We can all agree that the 24-month waiting period, the so-called Medicare gap, it doesn't make sense. Why should people who suffer severe disabling conditions have to wait 24 months from the onset of those conditions to get health care? Social Security knows they need health care. They need it and they need it now. And they've qualified for disability. So why put a hold on it? Why wait? Why does Social Security make disabled people suffering severe disabling conditions, why does it make them wait 24 months to become eligible for Medicare? Well, the answer is Social Security doesn't make anyone wait. It doesn't make anyone wait 24 months or any time. It didn't make the law. Congress makes the laws, and Congress needs to investigate and fix the Medicare gap. that's not going to happen unless we discuss it. So what does Social Security say we should do during the 24-month Medicare gap? It doesn't say anything. Instead, the Department of Health and Human Services makes suggestions at healthcare.gov, link below. Healthcare.gov suggests two options. First, you may qualify for Medicaid. Yeah. You may get SSDI, but you may still qualify for Medicaid. If you're eligible for Medicaid, your Medicaid eligibility may continue even after you enrolled in Medicare. So when your waiting period is over for Medicare, you enroll in it, you don't lose your Medicaid. As we discussed, disabled persons who are awarded SSI receive medical care. They receive Medicaid without any waiting period. And those who are awarded SSDI may also qualify for Medicaid if they meet the poverty requirements of SSI. Healthcare.gov tells us that you can apply for Medicaid in two ways. They tell us about two ways you can apply for Medicaid. First, you can create an online account or log in to complete an application for Medicaid. Make sure you answer yes when asked if you have a disability, and they will forward your application to your state Medicaid agency. Second, you can apply directly to your state Medicaid agency. There's a link below. So what do you do if you're not eligible for Medicaid? You can wait. Healthcare.gov tells us that if you're turned down for Medicaid, you may be able to enroll in a private health plan through the marketplace, affordable health care, while waiting for your Medicare coverage to start. You may qualify for lower cost on marketplace coverage based on your income and household size. Healthcare.gov tells us, when asked about your income on your marketplace application, be sure to include your SSDI income. Do it so you avoid any kind of unnecessary delays in processing. Number two, for more information, visit healthcare.gov at the links below. This is important. Somebody's come up with this private insurance product. They call it the Medigap insurance. Yeah. So there is Medigap insurance, and that gets a lot of attention. And it sounds like it would help in that it would offer health coverage until, you know, your Medicare gap ends. But there's no such thing. Medigap insurance doesn't cover the 24-month gap in Medicare eligibility for those who receive SSDI benefits. Medicare Solutions, a private insurer, tells us that the so-called Medigap coverage is a Medicare supplement. It's not a Medicare substitute. Medicare Solutions tells us that Medicare supplement insurance, also known as Medigap, is a private form of medical insurance that covers out-of-pocket costs not covered by original Medicare, such as deductibles, co-payments, and co-insurance. With the Medicare supplement plan, you can go to any doctor that accepts Medicare. You're not limited to a network. If you're enrolled in Medicare Parts A and Part B and you're 65 or older, you may be eligible for Medicare supplement insurance. So don't get fooled if you hear about Medigap coverage. Don't be fooled. If you believe that this video would help other disabled people, please share, like, and subscribe so that they can watch it. Thank you for watching the Disability Granted channel, and good luck.